more of you, Lord. The only answer to everything that we need is more of Him. Amen. More of all that He is, more of your love, more of your joy, more of your power, more of your gentleness, more of your peace, more of your glory, more of you, Jesus, more, 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 more. Hallelujah. More, 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 more. And we've been making room for you. We've been making room for more of you in every area of our lives, spiritually, emotionally, physically. We've been making room for more of you. We don't really know what that means. We're just making room. We're just removing this and letting go of that. And we're just making room for more of you. Moving, moving, moving every area of our lives. Hallelujah. We don't want just a visitation, but a habitation. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. More, 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 more. And no matter what we're expecting tonight and every day of our lives, no matter what we ask, no matter what we think, according to your word in Ephesians 3:20, you always do exceedingly abundantly. Hallelujah. Above. More. You always do more. You call us more than a conqueror. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. More. We give you praise for the more of you in Jesus' name. We're not asking you for a Cadillac. We're not asking you for any material things. We're not asking you for stuff. Take the stuff away and give us more of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Strip us down. Whatever you need to do. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. Whew. Because tonight we're pressing more for the more. Amen. Help our ears hear more. Help our heart be more focused upon you. Help us hear your word tonight that we will not be thinking about other stuff. Help us just focus more on you. What a privilege, Lord, together tonight in one accord in your presence to hear from you. What a privilege. Thank you for giving us this place and one another, and we just give you praise for all that you have for us tonight, because it is more of you. We give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. More, more, more. Whew! I don't know about you, but it'd be nice to be so filled, to be spilled. And have you ever gone through stuff that I'm like, Lord, no more? I'm like, Lord, I need to drive. I need to... no more. Because His presence is so wonderful. He comes upon you in such a way that you can barely move. You're just like, whoo, hallelujah. Whoo. The other day I almost put toothpaste on my face. Oh my goodness. You should see me in my bathroom getting ready. It's funny. Lord, you need to show me. You need to help us walk in the natural. The Holy Spirit is increasing His presence in our lives. Tonight, I believe, is the seventh message on the crossover. Ah, the crossover. Looking at the book of Joshua in in connection to the spiritual truth that the book of Joshua means for us, when the children of Israel, led by Joshua, crossed over the Jordan, crossed over and walked in the promised land, where we in Christ, of course, we are in him, and the promises are of God are in Christ, and they are yes and amen. And we have seen walls come tumbling down. We've seen how once they cross over, I don't want to go through everything that we have seen, but I want to kind of pull it all together tonight with a crossover, with this that I heard in my spirit before the service when I heard it's over. I heard it's over. And I said, Lord, what's over? I don't know about you, but I have a whole list of things that I would like them to be schlag over. Amen? And he said, there's some things that I have finished that are over. There's some things, because of who you are in me, that have been done. They've been finished. And as I'm leading the people to cross over, to be able to walk in that place that they have crossed over, there are some things that are going to be finally over because of the revelation that some things already are over. Because if you think about it, the reason why he had the children walk around Jericho all the days had to do with changing their attitude towards their Jericho. At times, there's some things, because we are in Christ, that God has a way to take us to a journey before he shows us that a situation has been handled, before he shows us that some walls are finally down. If he would do it too fast, we might not learn some of the great lessons that we learn from him. He set me free from a whole lot of things when I got born again, but for some reason, I was still smoking cigarettes. And for 3 years, I was just having such a battle with that. But I was so on fire for the Lord, I was reading the Bible with my cigarettes. I was worshiping with my cigarettes. One day I looked in the concordance to see if it says cigarettes, to see what I could learn about cigarettes. Then one day I said, Lord, what did it take you so long? When finally he set me free, you heard my story. I did my own baptism. I was reading Watchman Nee, The Normal Christian Life, and all the, I get such a revelation of the baptism of the death, of identifying with his death, and then identifying with his resurrection. That I did a bath water so that the cigarettes could stay in. Hallelujah. And I didn't have withdrawal symptoms, nothing. It was just the most beautiful thing. Why? Because I had a revelation of what was over. Of what I already had been freed from, that I needed to walk in. And I said, Father, why did it take you so long? 3 years. He said, because if I did it right away, you would have thought you had something to do with it. That's right. Said, I took you through the journey that you had to die to yourself. Well, thanks a lot. And there's something about the crossover generation that's connected to our recognizing that we are dead in Christ. That we are, our life is risen in him, and the gospel is all around the cross. So we cannot be the crossover generation without the cross. because of what Jesus did for us on the cross. So many things that he said, Telehestai, it is finished. It is finished. I've set you free from death. So when death knocks at your door, declare, no, that's over. When sickness knocks at your door, no, no, that's over. We're not going to go back there. So when I think of the abundant life that we've been looking at, and I have my cross here, and the cross is the way for me to walk in the abundant life. But you will notice that once I recognize what has been done on the cross, that I have to move past what the cross has done. I have to know what's over here so I can walk in it here. I have to cross over what's no longer able to threaten me so that it doesn't get over me. I have to know the truth of the gospel right here, so that I can move in resurrection life over here. The scripture in Colossians, oh, I'm so excited. And I just can't hide it. I'm about to lose control, and I think I like it. Now remember, God helped Joshua possess the land by removing and dispossessing the land of all the inhabitants, all the evil. And we saw, like Jericho, we presented the world. We can see that then he took them to be able to confront Ai, which was another city that represented the inward war with the flesh. That in order to conquer that, they had to deal with Achan, he was hiding sin in the camp. And once that was revealed, once we confess our faults to him, then we can possess more of things. Well, we can't even get there if we don't realize that by his stripes, we have been set free from things that we would try to hold on to. And then we see them conquer Gibeon, which represents the devil, deception. Things that appear one way, but they're really another way. And then in the future, after now that we will cross over, we're going to learn more about spiritual warfare, how to deal with those things. Because God is raising you up to be an army in his name, to call some things to move, to call some things to be still. Just the same way that Joshua called forth the sun and the moon to be still. God helped Joshua during that day that the sun and the moon stood still. The reason that he did it was to give Joshua time to conquer the enemy. We, in the book of Ephesians, are told to put on the whole armor of God and to stand. And when you have done all that you can do to stand, that you may withstand the enemy. And there's a place that God is taking us to be able to pray, time be still. Yes. So that we can have time to do what we're supposed to do. To speak to some things and say, slow down in the name of Jesus. For time to no longer have authority over us, but we take authority over the time to the point that we will redeem the time. Yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So we see all this And then in Colossians chapter 2, we read in verse 11 to maybe 15, in him, that is Jesus, you were also circumcised with a circumcision made without hands by putting off the body of the sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ, buried with him in baptism, in which you also were raised with him through faith in the working of God, who raised him from the dead. And you, being dead in your trespasses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, he has made alive together with him, having forgiven you all trespasses. All trespasses. Having wiped out. Not you. Every time you tempted to be wiped out, remember, I'm not going to be wiped out. So it's an incredible thing that's happening in the spirit right now, because spiritual warfare is increasing and God is causing us to be still in the midst of it. Total peace. But he says, having wiped out the handwriting of requirements that was against us, which was contrary to us, and he has taken it out of the way, having nailed it to the cross. Having disarmed principalities and powers, he made a public spectacle of them, triumphing over them in it. In what? In the cross. In what? In the cross. No wonder in chapter 3 it tells us to seek those things that are above. There's something that's so powerful about the crossing over when you understand that the cross made some things be over. And then when you walk as a disciple, dying daily, because in Luke we read that he said, if anyone wants to follow me, pick up your cross daily. Daily and follow me. The problem is that sometimes we stay there at the cross. The revelation of what the Lord has done on the cross is to help us cross over the place of death so that we can walk in the newness of life. The point of the cross is that we can walk in the power of his resurrection. We die daily, we pick up our cross. We die daily so that we can live. The cross is not a place of death, it's a place where death was conquered. So we die to our flesh because now we walk in the spirit. Jesus is alive. So I can cross over when I know some things are over. And I can know that I am over some situations when I walk in the victory that he says you have triumphed in him. And you learn to not only cross over some things, but declare that some things are over in your life. So many times we get stuck in some things that really are not alive anymore. That we have got to get to the point that, no, I'm not going to stay here. I'm no longer a smoker. I'm no longer an alcoholic. I'm no longer a drug addict. I no longer look for approval of man. I no longer use the wisdom of man. I no longer do this, I no longer do that, because Christ nailed it on the cross. He nailed my inability for me to deal with the flesh. He took my flesh, he took who I was, and he nailed it to the cross. And I identify with that death, and now I walk in newness of life. And let me tell you, it's not easy. But the crossover generation is a generation that trusts God for everything, that depends on him, that wholly follow the Lord, that live a life that you are totally surrendered to Him. And you believe in what He has for you because you believe that all you want is more of Him. You want His life. You want His presence. So when you find that you're disappointed with yourself, then you recognize, well, that means I depended on myself too much. You realize, well, if I'm hard on myself, now I'm helping the enemy because the enemy is the accuser of the brethren. And he's trying to kill me, but he cannot kill something that's already dead. He has no power over you because it's no longer you who live, but Christ who lives in you. And the life that you now live, you live by faith in the Son of God. Do we truly believe that Joshua talked to the sun and the moon and told it, be still? Because there's some things that we need to speak in our lives and cause it to be still. There's some authority that we need to walk in, that we need to understand what the Lord has done. Jesus is coming back, but He's not coming back to die on the cross. He has done that. He wants us to partake of everything that He has done. The crossover generation is the generation that know the power of the cross. Sometimes we don't hear any teaching about the cross anymore. Like maybe it's not powerful. It's so powerful that we don't really need any other message. If we can get the message of the cross, then we can receive the message of eternal life. If we can get it, that Jesus really died for our sins, then sin can no longer hold us down. If we can understand that Jesus conquered death, then we know that we have eternal life. We have hope. Even when our loved ones are passed on, we do not sorrow as those who have no hope because we believe. We believe. We believe. A crossover generation, it means that you're standing on what He did on the cross. And that your trust is only on what He has done. He said it is finished on the cross. He said, I have carried your sorrows. I have taken care of everything. You're going to have tribulation. He said, be of good cheer. Because I have overcome them all. And I'm calling you to be more than overcomers. You're going to go through things that you have to conquer, that you have to wonder what's happening. But I'm going to take you step by step, lesson by lesson. I'm not going to let you conquer all your enemies at once. I'm going to help you deal with things one at a time. Thank you, God. But with everything that He leads us to deal with is to give us that revelation of what He already has done. Have you ever been in a place, you know, when you're growing in the Lord and he suddenly, by His Spirit, show you something that you need to deal with, a battle, a problem, whatever it is, and He brings light on it. And you become so grateful because you're like, oh, Lord, I'd never seen that before. Because you know that He reveals to heal. So if He shows you something, you know that He's bringing His presence, His glory to take care of it. Isn't that the most wonderful gospel you ever heard? It's the only gospel. It is the power. The cross is the message of God, is the power to all those who believe. But you find yourself at crossroads in your life. The crossroad, we know, is whatever's coming your way, that you have to make a choice. Like we read in Joshua, you have to choose this day whom you will serve. So you're at a crossroad, you have to remember the cross. You can't pick the easy way out if the Lord is not in it. No matter the cost, even if it costs you to die to some stuff, you're going to cross over. The message of the life that we have in Christ is not that we have everything easy. He's empowering us to go through the difficult things because he went through it. He has crossed over. For the joy that was set before him, he gave his life so we could live. So when we go through tough stuff, we can't be running. We can't be turning around. We can't be thinking maybe there's an easy way out. No, because he's the way, the truth, and the life. So Lord, help us tonight cross over by understanding what you already have done, that the message and the lessons that we have learned, we are not going to go over them over and over and over and over again. That some of the lessons that we have gone through are going to be over. Or there'll be some other lessons. But there's some things that needs to be over. There's some battles that you know, it's 2016 and, you know, we've been facing the same giants for. And tonight, I declare unto you, it's over. Let's pass over. Let's go over those things. Let's receive everything that he has done and receive his glory, his presence, his power to help us just cross over the situation. Yeah. Jericho remained Jericho, but as they walked around it, their attitude changed. And what looked to be a problem that couldn't be handled just became a battle that the Lord, their God, was going to fight for them and with them. Whatever we're going through, we have to know that he's with us. And he's going to fight with us, for us, because of the battles that he already has won on the cross. In the spirit, we are right at the threshold. A threshold. A threshold is when there's a door that's halfway open. You're not really in. But the door is no longer closed. The door is open and you are entering in. You're no longer knocking at the door to make sure it's going to open. But you understand that through the cross, he has opened his way to everlasting life. And you're learning to walk in it. To walk in the spirit, to walk in the things that he has done, to pass over the place that you were in order to walk forward into what he has. The Holy Spirit, he's like gently pushing us, you know, like the body's there and he's like, okay, my yoke is easy, my burden is light, I'm gonna take you, I'm gonna drag you, no matter what I need to do, I'm just gonna take you over there. He's so gentle, that he's so patient with us, with every battle that we go through. Every battle that you go through, he takes us to the place to remember, oh, I remember, Lord, what you have done, and I remember who you are. And I no longer always ask you to do something in my future. I'm enjoying your presence now. The Lord is going to heal some people of things that they stopped praying to be healed from. He's going to cause some things to be still, just like the sun and the moon. For us, it could be time. To have time to take care of some stuff. But it could also be some enemies that we call them forth, go no further, to be still. It's wonderful to be able to fight just one battle at a time. But now there's something that has shifted, that instead of one battle, you're going to have many to fight. It's great when you have one battle and you deal with it and you're done and okay, next. But the way that the enemy is increasing his conniving ways is that he's battling us from every side. So that we don't really have time to really focus and command this thing to be still, because this other thing is moving so quickly. We don't have time to take authority over this because something is right there attacking us. So what do? When we're bombarded by all this, we remember the victory that we have in Him. We have the victory in Him. It's in Him that we are victorious. It's from that victory that we stand. No matter how many enemies we face, we have still the victory. We already have it because it's over. When Jesus died on the cross, He said, "Tetelestai," it is finished. Over, done with. Hallelujah. And there's a place of standing in Him that we are going to find ourselves, and I believe it already has begun, that is totally supernatural, to be able to stand still. It's supernatural. The Lord is releasing an anointing for you to be able to no longer be under some things, but to get over it because you have crossed over. You have crushed over. There's even some things that have been done that you haven't heard yet that's been done. Some things that you are concerned about, wondering what's going to happen, and you're about to hear what the Lord has done because of already what He has done for you, because He's fighting for you. The Lord is real. He's fighting for you, for me, for all of us. He loves you. He cares for you. He's watching over you. He's watching over His word. He's working on things. And He just says, just be still. Just cross over. Many times by your spirit, in your heart, you have got to just remember and say, "Lord, by your stripes, I am healed." And then I come here. "Lord, you carried my sorrow. I have joy. Lord, 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 I know, I know, I know that I know that I know that you took care of this mind battle that I have. You took care of all those thoughts. I have the mind of Christ. Lord, I know you know what those people did was wrong. And you know, I am so hurt. I am so offended. I am so hurt that this happened to me. But it's been nailed to the cross. I'm going to forgive because I've been forgiven. And now I'm going to walk in my victory. Lord, you know, whether it's the sin, whether it's the flesh, the devil, or the world, you know I'm bombarded. But I know that on the cross, you nailed all of it. And you disarmed it. And I am in you and you are in me. So I'm going to walk in the victory. I'm not gonna think all day long about the enemy. I'm not gonna talk about the enemy. I'm not gonna talk about some things that you have declared have no longer any power over me. None of those weapons that's formed is gonna prosper because I am with you and I am seeking those things that are above, not beneath. Because I am in you. And then you can partake. If you understand the cross and what's been done, the enemy will never be able to drag us from here back to here. If we know that we are here in our spirit, then no matter what happened in our lives, we will not walk by fear, but by faith. It's time to cross over because we have already crossed over. It's time for us to be able to command some things to be still. I told the Lord earlier today, I said, Lord, the time is flying. Like, I said, Lord, September. In case he didn't know, I thought I would tell him, Lord, it's already September, tomorrow. And the Lord said, I am outside of time. I see the beginning and the end. Eternity is outside of time. I see what's in your future, what's in your past. And I want you to redeem the time. He's going to cause us to walk in a speed to be able to do what he's called us to do. And you know how he's going to do it? By causing some things to be still until what he wants us to do is done. What is it that you've been sensing in your spirit that's not over, that the Lord wants you to know it's over? Are you waiting on something? There's people on the floor. The Lord said it's over. The Holy Spirit can touch one person and cause some things to be completely over in 1 second. He does that when we're born again, but he also does it when we pick up our cross daily. To pick up our cross daily, he said, if anyone wants to follow me, it doesn't mean if you want to go die on the cross, pick up your cross. No. He said, pick it up. Because if you pick up your cross, that means that you know that death can no longer hold you. If you pick up your cross, then your cross cannot pick you up. If you pick up your cross to follow him, that means that the same way that he went on to walk in resurrection life, you're walking in resurrection life. You pick up the fact that you are dead with him. You pick up your cross by picking up the revelation that you have that you are now a spiritual being. So powerful, the revelation of the cross. I'll never forget, it changed my life. Even after I was born again, to have a revelation of the cross. That's how I quit smoking, just like that. And that's how daily, whatever you're facing daily, you have to remember and cross over by carrying your cross, because he carried you. So he doesn't want you to carry the burdens, the fear, the worries. Say, no, I don't want you to carry that. I carried it. I want you to carry your cross. I don't want you to carry the worry. I want you to carry the cross. I don't want you to carry the financial burden. I want you to carry your cross, to carry the fact that you are dead to it and it's dead to you, and that I am with you. I feel the presence of the Lord that tonight on this altar, some things that we've been carrying can be left here, that it can be over. It can be over, even emotional things. There's some people that are holding resentment for other people and situation, and it's like, get over it already. I mean, I know some things take a long time, but there's some things that we carry that it's not for us to carry any longer. We need to walk free from those things. Some of it has to be ourselves. We need to stop being mad at ourselves. We walk around with a big hammer. Bad, 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 bad. No, we need to walk with the power of the cross, forgiving, 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 forgiving. Alive in Him, alive in Him, alive in Him. Amen. We're gonna finish the crossover message with our last prophetic act as we step over. And whatever it means in your life that needs to be left behind, let it be left behind today. But not you. Let's make sure that you're not wiped out. Left behind. The Holy Spirit is releasing a strengthening, when you put the red and black thing on the thing to do the jumping. You saw it, huh? So the black and the red thing and the cables, and you put it, and if your battery is dead, there's like, and it comes back, a charge, a recharge. The Holy Spirit tonight is going, he wants to give us a jump. And this jump's going to take us over. He's going to touch us, and he's going to jump us over the situation. Hallelujah. Lord, take us over. Lord, give us a jump. Holy Spirit, charge us. Except let your positive remove the negative. Just completely, just zap us. Zap us, jump us. Oh, we never pray that. Jump us, Lord. Jump us, Lord. Recharge us, Lord. Slack us, Lord. In such a way, because the enemy is trying to bring discouragement to people, cause people to grow weary and be discouraged and act like we are dead to him. No, we're dead in Christ. Big difference. Doesn't mean that we're not here and we let everything happen. No, it's the opposite. We can move in the Spirit and command some things to be still. I'm going to cause for some things to be still right now. Lift up your hands. In the name of Jesus, I call forth every attack that has come against you to be still. I put a restraining order over everything that has come to attack you and your families. I declare you will go no further. Be still in the name of Jesus. I speak forth to time, and I cause for time to stop while we do what we're supposed to do. I call forth a turnaround, a supernatural redemption of time in our life, that it will be so supernatural that instead of looking at the days go by quickly, we will say, Lord, look what you have done in such a small time. Hallelujah. We cast forth even some enemies that have been just attacking us and bombarding us. We command them to be still now in Jesus' name. I see like a protection being placed all around the body of Christ. Oh, it's a glory, it's a fence of glory. That the Lord said, you will be surrounded by my glory. It's a fence of glory. It comes with my protective shield. It comes with my strength, and I'm placing it all around you, around your mind. That the Holy Spirit says there's some battles in your mind that tonight are over. Tonight it's over. There's even some situations that you've been battling with family members, and the Lord said it's over. It's over. It's over. And there's some things that we've been going back and forth, that at times we think, okay, this is over, and then it comes back. And we know it's over, and then it comes back. The Lord says it will not come back any longer. It is over, 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 over. Hallelujah. Stand to your feet and declare, it's over. I have crossed over. I pick up my cross and I follow you. I walk in eternal life, abundant life. I have no fear. I have the victory because it's over. It's done. Thank you, Jesus.